Lakeview Terrace, and I just want to urge you to co-sponsor a bill recently sponsored by Representative Ted Deutsch. I don't know where he's from.
He's from Florida.
Yes. And the bill is to sponsor a congressional amendment ruling stating clearly that corporations are not people.
I have co-sponsored a similar amendment. Thank you for letting me know that Ted has one. I'll take a look at his, and if it's as good as the one I've co-sponsored, I'll co-sponsor that as well. Just the there are a few innocuous laws that define corporations as persons in the sense that no person can pollute the river. Obviously, if the corporation does that, they're in trouble as well. But the Citizens United case starts with the view that corporations are persons, therefore they have free speech rights, therefore they can spend millions of dollars helping individual politicians get elected, and everything's fine. The Supreme Court has recognized that you've got two interests here. One is political speech. Supreme Court likes it. First Amendment protects it. And I'd hate to say this in case anybody knows anybody here in South Carolina, but according to the Supreme Court, more political commercials are better. Okay. But then the Supreme Court realizes there's a countervailing concern. And that is that you want to not have a whole Washington filled with elected officials who are afraid of or beholden to particular giant corporations or very wealthy individuals. And so for our own campaigns, the Supreme Court has upheld the idea that you limit the contribution to $2,500. Now, if somebody gives $2,500 to my opponent, I prefer they not do that, but I don't quake in fear over that. If somebody donates $2,500 to me, thank you very much, but no, I'm not going to come over and wash your car every week. And so I'm certainly not going to have that influence anything I do. So the Supreme Court recognizes they like to see more congressional campaigns put with as much robust speech as possible, but there has to be a limit in order to prevent undue influence. Then, showing that they either hate campaign finance reform or have no understanding of the electoral process, and none of them have ever run for office, so it might indeed be the second, although I worry that it's the first, they come up with the idea that, well, if somebody gave $2,600 to my campaign and I got to be involved in making a TV commercial or designing the brochure, I would feel too beholden to it. But if somebody spent $260,000 sending out mail telling everybody how wonderful I am, I wouldn't feel beholden to them because I wasn't personally involved in selecting the color scheme. I have news for you. Elected officials like campaign brochures to be sent out because they want to win elections, not because we're, frustrated designers who just enjoy the process of selecting the picture for the brochure. They have convinced themselves, and it is absolutely bizarre, that those who are, one man gave Newt Gingrich $5 million on one day, and the Supreme Court's position is, that couldn't possibly give that person any influence because Newt didn't get to decide which TV station in Charleston the advertisements appear on. And that same Supreme Court says if somebody gave them Newt $2,600, that would be unduly corrupting. That's insane. I support every effort, and I've added it also to my personal life. I have pledged in my own race that, I don't believe in unilateral disarmament here. It's got to be a mutual pledge. But I've signed, subject to my opponent's signing, the statement that says this. If we could just come to a public forum and say, please don't anybody put $250,000 into a fund that's going to get me reelected. Please don't do that. Wink, wink, nod, nod. That's obviously the case. What I've done instead is say this. If somebody spends money in this independent campaign to help me, and they spend $100,000, I'll take $100,000 out of my campaign and donate it to the U.S. Treasury for deficit reduction. Now, this is not going to reduce the national debt. Once I make that statement, it basically tells everybody, you can't help Sherman by writing a check to an independent expenditure committee or a super PAC. Because every dollar you put in, he's got to take money from his campaign and give it to Geithner, Secretary Geithner. I've signed that. It's binding just as soon as the other candidate signs it. And if we both sign it, then there won't be super PACs operating, at least here in the San Fernando Valley. But the fact that the fact that people are donating $1 million at a clip to help people get elected to federal office, and the fact that that drowns out the influence. I mean, you could spend a lifetime gathering 100,000 signatures and hope addressed to a senator or a congressman in general, and you'd always wonder, are those 100,000 signatures that you spend your whole lifetime gathering as influential as some guy down the street who wrote a $100,000 check? So I hope to, there's a few people here where we're going to have a big political campaign here in the Valley. My hope is that there are no 100,000.